MA Lighting added another cool feature to the GrandMA3 software 2.2, and that is the tags feature. And when I saw it the first time, I was like, what do I need tags for? But the more I work with it, the more I play with it, the more brilliant I think it is. So let me just show you some of the obvious ones here in the beginning, and then we're gonna go into some not so obvious ones and some really helpful ones by the end of the video, so stick around. Let's start with looking at the obvious one. If you have a wash color sequence, as I have here, I have a wash color sequence and a spots color sequence. It just changes colors for the fixtures. So what I can do is I can go into my settings here, and you can see I added a tag here, which is a wash tag, and I did the same thing in my spots group. I added a spots tag. And to add a tag, I just want to show you this real quick. If you have your tags library right here, if you don't know or you can't see it anywhere, you simply just go in and create a window like this. You go into pools, and you open the tags pool. And you can see I created a lot of tags here, and I'll get into those in a second. The first things we're going to start with here is the spot and wash tags. So I just showed you I added them to this, and I can say go tag wash, and you can see it activates the wash sequence. And this could be many things depending on what you want to do. I can do the same thing with the spots like this, put quotation mark, and then it goes to the next one. Another thing I can do is I can search for a specific color. I have all my colors here in both sequences. The sequences are identical. The only thing is it changes color on different fixtures. But what I have done here is I tagged every cue with the tag for the color, for the corresponding color. So I have white, cyan, magenta, and all the way down here. So what I can do now is I can search for the tag and search for the sequences with using like an if statement. So if I want to go into blue with all my sequences, everything that is tagged with blue, I can say go sequence one through, which is all sequences, cue one through, which is all cues in all sequences, but only if tag is blue. And if you see the sequences up here, as soon as I press, these both hop into the blue queue. And you can do that across many different sequences depending on what you want to do. I definitely see some value in this based on if you're doing like busking shows and these festival busking things. You can definitely build your show using tags, and it's going to be a lot easier to rearrange stuff afterwards. Let's say you made some kind of mistake, you want to have your structure different, you can swap everything around, it doesn't matter, because it's searching for the tag. So that's one way of using tags. Let's just say we need another way of using tags. Let's give them a new tag. So I have my wash tag here, I can actually add another one, and I prepared one here called list. I had to give it some sort of name, and I give the other one a list as well. So now these two have two tags each, basically. One is list and one is the corresponding spot or wash. These two sequences now have the list tag as well. So what we can do is we can go into the list tag here, and we can go up into tag type, and we can set it to kill instant. And this is basically another way of doing what we used to call off on override. If you have two sequences and you have the same kind of value, color or beam or whatever, but the same value, often overridden would be that if you activate another sequence that has the same parameters as the first one will be killed. But that has to be the same, it has to have the same parameters inside. Here it doesn't matter, so if we just try and off these two sequences right now, we off both of them like this, and I go the first one, you can see now it goes into white. As soon as I go the other one, this one is killed. And that is basically how this works. So if you tag a lot of sequences with the same tag, and you set this setting, it's going to be killed as soon as you go another sequence with the same tag. There's another option in here, because we have a fade time. Over here, you can't see that, I'll show you here. We have a fade time of 2 seconds, but this one, as you can see, it kills the other one instantly. The other thing we can do is go into edit and we set it to kill delayed, and that will basically just kill it when the first one is done. So it lets the queue run, and as soon as the queue is finished, it's gonna kill the first sequence. That's another way of using tags. There is three more things I wanna show you where you can use tags in a cool way. The first one is when you program a song, you sometimes have to repeat yourself. Let's say you have a verse that comes again and again and again. You have a chorus that comes again and again and again. And these cues often have to be the same. And then you find yourself copying from one to the other, and that's fine, it works. But sometimes if you then do a change in one of them, you have to remember to do the other ones, remember where they are, stuff like that. You can actually use tags for that as well. And I think this is amazing. So let's see, we have a song here. I have just start song, intro, verse, chorus, verse, and so on down here. And what I have done is I tagged all the different cues depending on what I want to do, depending on something where repetition will always be a problem. I know my start song will always be the same. That's just the way I work. And then you have verse and verse two, and then you have chorus one, two. I think I made three here just to do something. And you can see I tagged all the cues with the corresponding tag. So let's just start by clearing this stuff here and say we want to take all our auras, we want to turn them on in blue, and we want to put them into state position number one. So let's store this based on the tag. So we say store cue one through, which is all cues, but only if the tag, I think it's called start cue. So basically we are storing all cues now, but only with the condition that the start cue is tagged in the sequence. So I say merge, and you can see it only stores it into the first cue. Brilliant. So let's see what else we can do. Let's make some sort of change here. We take all the Mac Ultras, we turn them on, we put them into red, and we give them a position here. We basically use the same command. Here we go. And then we do it based on verse. And we merge that in, and you can see it's stored two cues now, which are identical. And let's do the last thing here, and we take all our ultras, we put in a gobo, we put them in wide, and we turn them on, put them up into the air, and we store cue one through if tag chorus like this. And we say maybe we want to do it cue only, and we merge that in, and you can see it now populated all the chorus cues. So let's just clear this and see what we have made. Very, very simple. We go into the first cue, it looks like it's supposed to. Nothing happens in the intro. The verse, we turn these guys on. In the chorus, you see they go up into the air. We stored it cue only, so they're gonna go back into the verse again. Once again, they're gonna go up in the chorus. We have a bridge here, and then up again, and we're done. So we did that very, very, very simple. So say you have 20 songs in your show, and you go in and you tag all the times you have a verse and all the time you have a chorus. It is super simple to create some sort of macro based on the selected sequence. And then you simply just say store chorus, and it just does it on all of them. This is another way of using tags in GrandMA3 2.2. The next thing we're going to look at is how you can access specific recipes if you want to. So I have the next cue list here. I just want to select it here. You can see I have two cues. I just put something into them. We have a stage cue here, and we have this one. Let's say we want to target all the washes. Because I tagged all the recipe lines with wash, let's see if we want to disable these things with a macro. So let's say we want to write a command that targets all the wash tags inside all songs, or basically everything you have done. If you want to disable something that looks odd, you cloned your show, and you just want to turn off all that stuff. There's many ways of doing it, but I'm just going to show you how you can do that using tags. So if we write this command, say set sequence 1 through Q 1 through part, which is all the recipe lines, 1 through, maybe if I could spell like this. And we're going to want to go into a property, and it's called enabled, and we want to set it to no. Oops, no, like this. But we only want to do it if the tag is called wash, like this. And now I need to make sure my quotations are right here, otherwise it's not going to work. And you can see, as soon as I press enter, they are killed, but everything else is still alive. It's only the tag called wash that actually gets targeted here, which is really, really amazing. So we can do the opposite, and we can just set it back to yes, like this, and we are back in business. And this is targeting all sequences, all cues, and all cue parts throughout your entire show, or all recipe parts throughout your entire show. So this is brilliant. The last thing I want to show you is something I'm going to use quite a bit, which is how you can open and close universes for merging. We use that all the time when you're doing system engineering on festivals. You have a client coming in with a console. You have, on one festival, you have 4 universes you need to open. Another one you have 12. Another one you might have 40 universes or whatever. So this is basically a question of writing a macro that will work on all of it. You don't have to change any of your macros. You simply need to change your tags inside your universes, because tags can be used almost anywhere. So let's go into the patch, go into the DMX universes, and you can see merge mode is turned off here. If I want to go into everything and just set it into prior merge, which is like the standard, I can do that. So let's say on this festival we have 12 universes. I go in and I take a tag here. I think I have one called merge somewhere. There we go. And we assign the merge tag to these universes. Normally, if you write a macro to open and close this, you'd say set DMX UNIVERSES universe 1 through property, and we go into quotation and say merge mode. Oops, I think there's a caps lock thing here. Merge mode, and we set it to, it's prior now, so we set it to off, and this should turn merging off on all universes. I press enter, and you can see everything changed here. So let's set this one back to prior merge, like this, and then we write the condition now based on the tag. So we again want to set it into off. Oops. But only if the tag is merge, like this. And when I press enter, it only does it on the tagged universes. I think this is amazing. And you can find tags everywhere in the software now. It works everywhere in the software, and you can use it for many different kinds of things. And this is probably just the beginning. You never know what they're going to do next, MA Lighting regarding tags and stuff like that. Definitely feedback from all the users is going to make changes, probably how you work with it. But I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you will join me again next time. And if you're not subscribed, you can click the subscribe button down in the bottom. And that way you're going to get notified every time I upload a new video. And of course, you are more than welcome to like the video as well if you found it beneficial in any way for your own GrandMA3 journey. I hope you're going to play with this at home. And when you do, I hope you have some happy GrandMA3 programming moments. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.